Hello, I'm Carrie Morrill, a research scientist with the University of Colorado and with the World Data Service for Paleoclimatology, or WDS-Paleo. The WDS-Paleo is operated by the U.S. National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration. I will be talking about our vision to modernize datasets that we have been archiving for the past three decades. The WDS-Paleo is one of the largest repositories of information related to past climate and environment from hundreds to millions of years ago. These data are critical for placing current human-forced climatic and environmental change into a long-term perspective. We were established almost 30 years ago. The data we house are from a variety of natural sources shown by the image here on the left. Data contributors to the WDS-Paleo are generally individual research teams, and the datasets tend to be small and heterogeneous. Last, our users include researchers, educators, governmental entities, and resource managers. Over the past several years, we've been working towards a goal of making our datasets more findable, accessible, interoperable, and reusable. This pyramid shows our roadmap for this. We recently completed a project to create a thesaurus of variable names called the Paleo Environmental Standard Terms, or PAST thesaurus. Our goals over the next several years are to establish a standard format for reporting age information and also to convert non-machine-readable text files to our operational machine-readable templates. All of this work is building towards data sets that are easy to integrate with one another and that support reuse. Two of the main challenges we face in this work are, first, being successful in engaging subject matter experts to help us in developing standards. And second, templating legacy data into machine-readable formats will be a resource-intensive process, and we are searching for creative ways to make this happen. Once these projects are complete, though, we will have enabled researchers to do more data-intensive science, combining datasets in new ways. Also, we will have made it easier for non-specialists and decision-makers to use these data for a variety of purposes. So thank you for listening, and here is our contact information and web address.